Okay. So now you know where the inspiration of the hilt comes from. Let's look at the hilt a bit more closely. Okay, so this is aluminium 6061. Okay, it has got the my signature Anakin the bunny ears. Okay. This is the bunny ears, and the bunny ears got one hole on one side. So that this is the side that we use to do to hang our, you can use it like a D-ring to hang the hilt from the belt using a carabiner instead of using a cover tech wheel. Okay, so there is no D-ring at the bottom, although there are some six holes here. If you want to, you can put it there as well. However, we have, based on the inspiration of our original, there is a hole here. Okay, so the middle part here is knurled. Okay, there's some knurling there, hope you can see. And then it has got two switch holes, one for the switch, one for the recharge port. Okay, of course, for some models you see that there are two switch holes here, especially models that require two switches. And then this recharge port, I will move it to the inside of the chassis there. Okay, now this part here is removable. Okay, I'll just show you. Okay, so this part here is removable. It's a bit tight now. So this is what we call the blade holder, or sometimes when you buy a Hasbro hilt or a Mazda replica hilt, and then the blade cannot fit inside. So basically they say they need a conversion kit. What's a conversion kit? Basically it's this. This is the blade holder. Okay. This one is can be opened up. Okay, you can put it inside, align it. Align it. So this part here has been flattened, and there is a space just nice to put in this bunny ear here, so that when you screw it down, it doesn't move. There's only one screw to hold the bunny ear in place. Normally one screw is not enough, but because this part here, this round part here, is already recessed and made flat, so there's a place for the bunny ear to sit, and then it cannot move. Once you tighten there, it cannot move anymore. Okay, so it's very secure. And then the second hole here is for the thumb screw. Okay, for this part here, of course the original one here is black, and this part here, there's a small lip here which is black. Okay, and this part, this the other one is also black here. Now if you want to, it doesn't come in black, but since that part is removable, if you want to, you can actually remove it, take it out, use a marker or whatever, and then just paint it black, like what I did here, and then put the lip there is also in black. Okay, so if you want, you can do that. If you really want to, you can even put two dots of gold there to to imitate the pins here. Last time I used to do it when I first came out and did the Anakin, I used to put two dots of gold. Then a lot of people who are not Star Wars savvy, they are very puzzled. Why is this two gold dots there? So after that, I didn't put the dots anymore. Okay, so back to here. So that's the front part. Behind part, this is the pommel, which is inspired by our Anakin model earlier on just now. Now some people tell me, why don't you do this one like that one? Why don't you do this like this? Why don't you do this like another model so it look more like the other model and those kind of things? So actually, I'm not trying to copy this model 100%. No. In fact, I don't want to copy it. That's why I came up with my own design. I want to make it more ergonomic, so it's easier to hold, and don't have the control button there, the control box there with the bulky one, so that it's easier to hold, slim and easy. And this is basically my design instead of a copy of the original Graflex design. Okay, so this is long and slim. Now for the back part here, there are two ways to remove to get to the back. One is in the middle, okay. Okay, this one. Because got electronics inside, huh? Wait, This one is stunt with no sound, so there's a different chassis. There are in total two different chassis for this system. One is for stunt and the other one is for with sound. So for the stunt one, okay, there is a handle here for you to pull out. You just pull out, and then inside here we will have the tray for you to put the battery. So this battery is AAA. So all you have to do is just take it out, change the battery, then put it back in. There's also a hole at the back. If you want to push it out from there, you can as well. Okay, so this is actually a very it's like a work of art kind of chassis, but basically just to hold the battery so it doesn't move around inside the hip. Push it back, slot it in, and then you see that it comes out a little bit. Why? Because this will meet at the end of the pommel here, so that by the time you screw in the pommel, is held securely between this part here and the pommel. The pommel push it in so that it doesn't move at all as well. Okay, so this one is only with light, no sound. Stunt. This is our cheapest model. Later I'll go through the pricing, but basically you'll be very surprised because the pricing is very very attractive. Okay, from the stunt model, the next level up will be a sound model. Now the sound model, we have got the premium sound with single color and premium sound with multicolor. So basically there is no basic sound anymore. Basic sound will be only for the UPVC model. Okay, so the UPVC model only will have the basic sound. For the aluminium one, you either have no sound or you go premium sound. So premium sound, you can have single. Let me put on the blade. Do I have a shorter blade? I use a long blade. So use the, when you put in the blade, use the thumb screw to tighten it. I forgot to mention just now that stunt model, it uses three pieces of AAA battery. So the once the battery has run out, the light is dim already, it throw the battery away. It's disposable battery and put new batteries. So those batteries are very cheap. IKEA battery, one box is about ringgit plus, and it's about less than $2. Okay, inside got 10, you can use 1 year so it won't finish. Okay, so that one is not rechargeable, it's disposable. And then for model with sound, of course we have this with a recharge port and a rechargeable battery. Now for here, the stunt model, you will see also there is a recharge port, whereas we only use this button for the light. So this recharge port has got no function at all. It's there just to cover the hole, to make it so that there is no hole there. So it's just basically a dummy recharge port. It doesn't do anything. However, should you decide to upgrade next time to a premium sound, at least here you already have got a recharge port, so immediately you don't need to drill holes and whatever, and then the recharge port is already there and can be used. Okay, so for the stunt model, one button, and then this one is a dummy recharge port. It doesn't do anything. Now for the premium model, this is the one button to control the soundboard. This one is a real recharge port, which you can do to charge the battery inside. Okay, let me show you the inside. So to get to the access to the inside, what you do is you twist in the middle, not at the end. Only for the stunt you use the end. Here you use the middle. So when you pull out, so we have the chassis here. The chassis is fixed to the hilt here. Okay, so this is the board with the wiring. This is the battery, the speaker. Okay, the recharge port is here. This is where you charge the battery. Okay, so I'm going to put this back in. So when you put this back in, the length here exactly is right up to the the length of the pommel right exactly there. So this thing here is secure, it cannot move at all front or back because it's sandwiched by the whole body here. Okay, okay, so this is our premium model to get the thing started. Now it's in what we call deep sleep mode, it's sleeping. So to get it started, you press this for about 5 seconds. Then it'll give you a sound to tell you that it's woke up already from deep sleep. And then this light here is lighted up. Okay, to tell you now it is in standby mode. To get it started, press one time. So this is flash on flash. Then you also got blaster blocks. Also got blade lockup. Hold one time, flash one time. Okay, so that's blaster block. So there is a swing activated motion. So when you swing it, it will follow your movement to give a sound. And then when you hit, it give you the clash sound. Plus a flash, we call it the flash on clash. Okay, let me just off this. So here we have 6 sound forms altogether. Some sound form has got the flickering blade, some sound form has got the solid blade, like just now it's a solid blade. Okay, so to change sound form while it's off, hold this down until it gives you the new sound form. Very loud, so that's the next sound phone. Okay, so this is the second phone, this one. This one has got a more flickering kind of a blade. Okay, so it has got all the same thing. So all together there are 6 sound forms. Some of them have a flickering kind of a blade effect, some of them have solid blade kind of effect. Okay, so depending on what is your preference, you can choose to have it in flickering, mild flickering, or you can have it in solid. So there are 6 different forms that you can choose. And if you find that if the sound is too loud, there is also 2 levels of sound plus mute mode as well. Okay, so to get into that, hold this until it flash for one time. One.
Softer sound.
Then it says softer sound now. Softer sound, which means now the sound is softer. Not as loud as just now. Okay, off. Hold until it turns off. Okay, then another one. Hold for one flash again.
No sound.
It says no sound. So this is mute mode. So when you press it, no sound. Okay, it still have the flash and all those kind of things. However, it's got no sound. This is in case if you want to practice in at night, you don't want to disturb people and those kind of things. So you just want to have just the light. Okay, off. Okay, and then one more time to the next sound level.
Loud sound.
So this is loud sound. So basically there are 3 levels of sound. Loud sound, soft sound, and no sound. Okay. Let me just change the third. This is the third sound form. So this one also has got some kind of a flicker there. This is the blade lockup. Okay, let me change to the next one. So far we've gone 2-3 already. Okay, this one also got a very strong flicker as well. Okay, that's the fourth one. Now go to the fifth one. Also a flicker. Very bassy, yeah. Okay, next one.
I'm a Jedi.
So this is the sixth
like
one.
Father before me.
This is Luke. So this is a solid blade. There is no flickering or whatsoever. Flash on flash. Buster block. Blade lock up. Okay. So that is our premium sound with single color. Okay. Then the next tier up from there, we also have what we call the premium sound but with multiple colors. Okay, so it's a different model altogether, different LED and but basically the rest of the thing is the same. So the sound font is the same. Okay, the blaster blocks, the flash on clash, the blade lockups, everything is the same, except that this card has the ability to have many different colors. So I'm going to show you now the premium sound with the multi-color. Okay, so let's move on to the okay. This is another sound font. Now this is also a solid blade. So same thing, got the flash on clash, blaster block, blade lockup. Okay, now besides this, we also have the ability to change color. So for this, I hold down this for 2 seconds. One, two, then let go. Then after that, I'm going to press this until it changes color. So you look at the reflection of that. So now it's purple, pink, red, orange, yellow, green. So you basically just continue to change color until it comes to one that you like. Okay, let's go to a different color altogether. Okay, let's say this one, purple, light purple. So if you like this, you press one time to confirm. So now it is purple in color. So it covers the entire spectrum of the rainbow, you know. So from what you can perceive, a lot of people say what it is 7 colors for the rainbow, but actually there's a lot more shades in between the 7 colors. So it's actually a very gradual kind of a change from one color to another. Okay. So that is the premium sound with, we call it the premium sound RGB. RGB stands for red, green, blue. It consists of the 3 different color dyes there. The 3 color LED will actually combine together and go into different various combinations to give you, if you go mathematical term, it's 16.5 million colors. But basically, we call it, it covers the entire spectrum of the rainbow. Okay, so that is the premium sound with RGB.